Hello friends, I am Mrs. Sampada Kulkarni, welcomes you in my channel Tech Talks. Today, I am going to talk about call by value type of function calls. Content of today's session are, first of all, we'll recall the function calls, then we'll go through its different types, from which I'll explain call or pass by value. I'll explain its example. I'll explain that example very well and then I'll explain its drawback. Objective of our today's session is every learner will be able to understand function calls, its different types, how to call them by passing parameters to it, and how to use them in programming. Let's recall the function calls. Here I have taken one example of function volume. First of all, how to declare it? It is declared with the help of return variable, function name, and its arguments list. Let's see the example where volume is a function where three parameters we need to pass. All are of them of type float and its return type is float again. This is function declaration. V1, L1 and B1, H1 are the variable declaration. L1, B1, H1 have declared with some values. Next line is nothing but a function call where we are calling a function by passing the parameters L1, B1, H1 and its values, and we are returning the return value in V1 variable. This is nothing but the definition of function volume, where we are performing a task of multiplication of L, B and H, where L, B and H are the variables which are formal arguments. L1, B1 and H1 are the actual arguments that we are passing from a function. L, B and H are the formal arguments which are declared in the function definition. Note is given is like, a value of formal argument changes in called function. The corresponding change does not take place in a calling function. What is the meaning of this statement? This only I am going to explain with this session. Function calls, there are two ways or two types of function call. The first one is call or pass by value, where we are sending the values of the arguments to the function. Second type is call by reference, where we are sending the addresses of the arguments to the function. Now let's see, what do you mean by call or pass by value? As I have explained previously, values are passed to function while function call. Now we'll see one example where we are performing the addition of two numbers with the help of function. The name is given to function is add. We are passing two parameters to it. Both are of type integer and its return type is integer. To perform the same task in main function, we have declared three integer variables A, B, on which we are performing the addition, and the result is a variable which will hold the result after performing addition. This statement is nothing but a function call where we are calling a function add by passing the values of a variable A and B. So here the control transfer from calling function main to called function add, and the values of A and B are collected in a variable X and Y respectively. One new variable r is declared to the function add. R is holding the addition of x and y, and we are returning the value of r back to the function, calling function, that is main. So now result is a variable will hold the address, will hold the addition of two numbers, and it will display result with the help of printf statement. What will be the output of this program? So friends, this is task given to you to execute this code and check what is the output of this program. We'll move forward. The next concept is, as the scope of variable is live only for current function, whatever changes are done are not applicable to the calling function. With this statement, what we have done in this particular program, so what was the addition performed by these two numbers and its result is returned back to the function, and result is a variable which is holding that result and it will display the result. So if you want to know the meaning of this statement, the previous example is not sufficient. For this, we'll see one more example in which we are trying to swap two numbers. As the variable a and b are declared with some values, we need to perform a task of exchanging the values of both the variables a and b by passing them to the swapVal function. And listen carefully, swapVal function is not returning anything, its return type is void. So whatever task we have performed in a swapVal function, that we are performing on a values of variable a and b. So now a and b are declared with the values 10 and 20. Before swapping, we are displaying the content of a and b. We are calling a function, control will transfer to swapVal function, where x and y variable are holding the values of a and b, that is 10 and 20 respectively. And here the task of swapping or exchanging of two numbers is done. At the end, in swapVal function, we are trying to display the content of x and y. And after that, we are returning back from a function by ending the function definition. And in the main function again, we are trying to display the content of a and b. Now, can you think about what will be the output of this program? So now here I am going to explain it again, how this program will get executed. Now let's see, in main function, two variables a and b are declared and initialized with the values 10 and 20 respectively. In swapVal function, two variables x and y are declared and the values of a and b are passed by call by value to the function. Next step is, the temp variable is declared and it is of type integer again. Next statement performs the assignment of content of x to variable temp. Next, the value of y is assigned to variable x. So here 20 is holding in the variable x. Previously it was 10 and now it is going to be 20. After execution of next statement, the value of y is going to be changed. That is, previously it was 20. After execution of the statement, it will become 10. And after printing, we are getting the output of x and y as equal to 10, 20 and 10 respectively. But after returning back to the main function, there is no any change in the content of variable a and b. They are 10 and 20 as it is. So that's why here values are not swapped at all. What was in the previous statement is, like, by passing the values to the function, there is no any change in a calling function. Changes are not happen with the variables in a called function. That is, the actual arguments A and B are as it is, and the changes are done with the only formal arguments. So, what does it mean? It means that by passing the values to the function or by calling a function by value, the changes are done with the function only. They are not reflected in a calling function. So, dear friends, you try this program whether the values will get changed with a calling function or not. And let's check the output. What will be the output before swap val function call and after swap val function call. Thank you.